بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين. بسم الله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. يا ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك وعظيم سلطانك. اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا وقلبا خاشعا ولسانا ذاكرا وتوبة قبل الموت ومغفرة بعد الموت والسلامة فيما عند الموت والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. آمين 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 يا رب العالمين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Syukur alhamdulillah muslimin dan muslimat yang saya hormati sekalian, kita bersama-sama seperti biasa untuk mendalami dan faham kitabullah Al-Quran. Insya-Allah akhlak kita, muamalah kita, segala behavior kita insya-Allah will be from the Quran insya-Allah. Even Sayyidah Aisyah herself, when people asked her how was akhlaq Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, she said kanat akhlaquhu al-Quran. And to let all of us know, akhlaq in Islam, morals, is very very important. Sebenarnya Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam dalam sebuah hadis yang sahih, he said what athqalu ma yudha'u fil mizan yawm al-qiyamah al-akhlaq. Yang paling berat timbang dia di hari kiamat, more berat than ibadah, is akhlak. And kalau kita berhati muslimin dan muslimat yang saya hormati sekalian, all the ibadah we do, whether it is salah, puasa, haji, zakah, all this ibadah is to membinakan akhlak kita. For example, salah teach you to be what? To be clean, to be also tertib, you know, to be consistent, to be a person yang menunai janji kepada Allah. I janji mesti break 5 times a day, I must do it, okay. Come to the zakat, teach you what? To be good with people. Remember orang yang miskin, you know, and you know very well that this is not my money, it's people's money, because Allah said fi amwalikum haqqun lis-sa'ili wal mahrum, dalam duit kamu ni ada hak untuk orang lain, so it is not mine, zakat, so I must give it away because it is not mine. Okay, hajj is a school for akhlaq, because you go to a place very small. And you know, you have to utter to go to the toilet, you have to be in the khima in Arafah. And if you don't have a good akhlaq, a good morals, sure you will misbehave and the hajj will not be accepted. So all the ibadah Allah give, even puasa, Allah said what? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. What is تَتَّقُونَ? You become fear Allah, because puasa will help you to fight with your desire. I cannot lose my temper easily, I have to sabar, I cannot cheat Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by eating, because Allah maha milihat saya, and I cannot get angry easily. So all this is also for akhlaq. So akhlaq ni, all the ibadah Allah give to us, rukun Islam, all to membinakan akhlak kita. That's why akhlak is very very important. That's why Rasulullah said what? When we look at the mirror and you see that you are human, you are not an animal, and you see that you don't have a tando, you don't have a hair, you look human, you know, you must say Allahumma hassin khuluqi kama hassanta khalqi. Ya Allah, ya Tuhanku, biarlah akhlak saya juga jadi baik seperti rupa saya. But most of us, we spend hours in front of the mirror, kita ingat doa. Betul tak? You must remember to read this doa. Allahumma hassin khuluqi kama hassanta khalqi. Ya Allah, ya Tuhanku, biar akhlak saya juga jadi cantik seperti rubah saya. And also after every prayer, Rasulullah SAW said, you must say to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika minan nifaq wa su'il akhlaq. Aku berlindung kepadamu ya Allah daripada nifaq, munafik, hypocrite, wa su'il akhlaq. Even hypocrite pun, kalau kita nak analyze hypocrite, Rasulullah said what? Orang hypocrite ni number satu is a haddasa kadhaba. When he talk, he is always lying, liar. It's also akhlaq. Idha awada akhlafa. When he promise, he never keep promise. It's also akhlaq. Idha atumina khana. Kalau dia amanah, rahsia ke apa kau, khiana amanah. He will, some people will tell him, don't tell people between me and you. Everyone will know. If you give him something to give to people, it will tak sampai. So, iza tu minakhan is also akhlaq. Apa lagi? Wa iza khasama fajara. Kalau dia gaduh dengan kawan dia, fajara. All the aib of his friend will come out. All the aib. And he will not only that. Tambah lagi, tambah lagi. Itulah iza khasama fajara. Wal'iyazubillah. Kerana itu, I got here one hadith that we should know is also about akhlaq, because insyaAllah Ramadan is coming, and Ramadan maklumlah is a bulan at-tawbah, syahrul tawbah. So maybe sometimes kita, if we don't do muhasabah diri now in Sya'ban, Ramadan come, Ramadan go, we are the same. No point lah to attend majalis al-ilmi. Because we attend majalis al-ilmi ni to baiki diri, to be better, better. Every time you come to majlis ilmu, you must go back. I feel I am better than before. I feel I am better than before. InsyaAllah. And that's why lah Rasulullah SAW buji sangat-sangat majalis al-ilmi ni. Because it can change us. Make us a best example of a Muslim, insyaAllah. Muslimin dan muslimat yang saya hormati sekalian, an Abi Mas'ud radhiyallahu anhu, qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, laysa al-mu'minu bit-tuhani wala al-la'ani wala al-fahishi wala al-badhi'. Nampak berkara, if it is in you, you are not a mu'min. It's very good to muhasabah diri. Mbak berkara ni Rasulullah said, laisal mu'min. You are not a mu'min if you are terlibat in mbak berkara ini. Number satu, ta'an. Suka ta'an means suka mencermar orang lain. Ta'an. Oh, she is always a liar. Oh, dia kedekuk tu. Oh, dia jahat tu. Memburukkan orang lain. Suka mencemarkan orang lain in the eyes of the others. You know, make others hate the someone. By what? Always saying bad things about that person. That's very, very bad. You are not mu'min. Because by right, as a Muslimah, or as a good Muslim, to tub'aib your friend. If people say, dia kedekuk misalnya, no lah, she is not that kedekuk, but just she, maybe she doesn't know how to behave, but I don't think she is kedekuk. But if you keep on saying, oh, dia kedekuk tu, oh, saya tahu dah kedekuk, itu tak bagus lah. Suka apa? Mencemarkan orang lain. Betul kan mencemar?
Yeah.
Oh, very good. Bahasa ya ni, oh. Okay. Number dua. Walal la'an. Suka melaknat orang. Laknat. Selak kalau dia tu. own shop. You cannot, you are not, you know, in Islam, you cannot even la'na the binantang, you know. You cannot, even, any makhluk Allah, you cannot la'na. It will come back to you. It will night, you cannot say, shalakat kucing tu. Shalakat ini, shalakat semua ni. Shalakat, cannot. Berkataan shalakat tu, you cannot use to any makhluk Allah. Cannot. Because Rasulullah said, if you la'na, it will come back to you. It will not go up, it will, Allah will la'na you. So be careful. So Iranian mu'min cannot la'na anything. Cannot. Okay. Apa lagi? Walal fahish. Suka denda keji. Betul? Cakap keji-keji. Some people lidah kotor. Fahish. They cannot talk nicely. Kalau marah si oblante. Astaghfirullahalazim. Itu we call them what? Fahish. Because Rasulullah said, is not the mu'min. Marah siki, mulut kotor straight away. Straight means what? Suka cakap keji-keji lah. Betul keji-keji.
Yeah.
Allah bandai lah hari ini malam ni saya. Very good. Walal badhi. Number four. Al badhi. What is badhi? Suka cakap benda yang lucu. Benda lucha. Betul juga kah tu?
Yeah.
Allah Akbar. Sudah very very good. So, I tanya husband saya berapa puluh kali. So, he's a good teacher lah. So, muslimin dan muslimah yang sahabat sekalian, tolonglah empat perkara ni sebagai orang yang alhamdulillah Allah bagi hidayah. You are a good Muslim, you are a good Muslimah. I will never terlibat in these four things, inshallah. Because Rasulullah said, laisa al-mu'min. That's why if you sit with someone and he is terlibat in any of these four things, he's not a good mu'min. The real mu'min, he never mencemarkan orang lain. He never melana Quran. He never buat benda-benda yang keji. He never cakap benda yang lucu. Yang tak ada guna. Very bad. Some people, Masya Allah, they have this character. Mudah-mudahan, we as a mothers, when we notice that our son come from the school, our daughter come from the school, because sometimes they get it from the school, you must show that you are very angry. As a good Muslimah, as a good mother, don't say all these bad words. We cannot say we are a Muslim, we are a mu'min. This is bad people only talk all this. Because it's also, Rasulullah said what? Al-mar'u ala ma shaba alayhi. You see the person, how he behave? This is his mother never scolded him. His parents never scolded him. Shaba alayhi. Man shabba ala shay'in, shaba alayhi, Rasulullah said. If anyone... Semenjak kecil macam tu, sampai tua is like that. Because no one to go. You must to go your son, to go your daughter. Come from the school, say, oh, bodoh, gila. You buat tak tahu gitu? Oh, very bad. Very bad. It will affect the character. Sampai tua pun, tak boleh tu kadang. Kerana itu, Muslimin dan Muslimah yang saya masih, how Islam is beautiful. And that shows us how Islam is beautiful. Saja kita... No, we don't really make a research, we don't find out. And this is all akhlaq. Some people, when you are sitting with them, not even bad word outside. And some people, you sit with them, jokes are, oh, kilo. What is this? You are not a mu'min if you do that. Inshallah, I'm pretty sure none of us like this, inshallah. But the more we know, the more we avoid, inshallah. Alhamdulillah, this was our muqaddimah. And alhamdulillah, we reach, and this is also very good for you to choose your nantu, to choose your partner. If you sit with your partner, masa tak ada siapa lagi kah yang nak kahwin lagi, sudah kahwin semua. Ada juga lah. If you sit with your future partner and you notice all these words come out, don't take him as a partner lah. it will be tough because the children will be like that. If the father like this, the children will be like that. The father should be the role model of the family. Only talk nicely, only comment nicely. Then salamat ana inshallah.